Good morning all. I have made this lecture Periodontal Reconstructive Surgery. This lecture is basically for final year BDS student. Following question may be there in final exams, long question and short notes. Let's start with the introduction. Regenerative periodontal therapy comprise procedures which are specially designed to restore those parts of tooth supporting structure that has been lost due to periodontitis. So basically we want to restore the structure that is lost because of periodontitis. In the diagram, on the one side there is healthy periodontium in which junction epithelium lies at cemento enamel junction, intact alveolar bone and healthy periodontal ligament structure. But on the opposite side, where periodontitis is there, destruction of underlying alveolar bone is there, destruction of periodontal ligament fibers is there, cementum is exposed and destroyed, and gingiva is inflamed. So we want to restore the structure that is lost due to periodontitis. So we want to restore alveolar bone. We want to restore the periodontal ligament structure, we want to restore the cementum and connective tissues of the gingival epithelium. Healing. How healing will take place when we do periodontal regenerative surgery? We want bone formation to be there, we want formation of periodontal ligament fiber to be there and gingival tissues to be there. Now, other important terminology are bone fill. The presence of bone tissues within the periodontal osseous defect following the periodontal therapy. Repair. It describes healing of a wound in response to injury in an attempt to restore normal structure and function. New attachment. Formation of new cementum, collagen fiber on previously denuded root surface of periodontal ligament. What are objective of periodontal regenerative therapy? Objective is we want reduction of pocket to be there. The pocket that is formed because of periodontitis, we don't want any pocket formation. Now, next is clinical attachment gain. We want clinical attachment. Attachment of the exposed root with periodontal ligament fiber. We want bone to be there. We want bone fill of the osseous defect. So that means we want new cementum and we want new bone formation and periodontal ligament structure. That means establishment of healthy maintainable environment. Now, how can we evaluate the new attachment in the periodontal regeneration? So various methods by which we can find out yes, regeneration has taken place is by clinical methods, radiographic method, surgical reentry and histological method. Clinical method. In clinical method, we will be comparing the pre-op and post-op clinical case with the help of periodontal probe. A probe can be used to determine the pocket depth, attachment level and bone level. But the major disadvantage is margin of error will always be there. Radiographic method. Careful standardization technique for reproducible positioning of the film and tube is to be done. And how we can find out the level of bone that is being formed by looking into the radiograph is from cemento enamel junction to the alveolar bone. And other method are subtraction, radiography and computer assisted densitometric image analysis. So this diagram shows how pre and post op comparison in radiograph. Surgical reentry. It provides a good view but major shortcoming with this surgical reentry is unnecessary second procedure is to be done. And second is we cannot make out the type of attachment that is there in histological method. Histological analysis of tissue block obtained from healed area. Disadvantage is that it need the removal of tooth with its periodontium, and so it is normally done in animal studies. Various reconstructive surgical technique that is done are first non-bone graft associated new attachment, in which we will not be using bone graft. Second is bone graft associated new attachment, and the next is combination of both. So in non-bone graft associated attachment, it can be achieved by the removal of junctional epithelium and pocket epithelium. Various treatment modality how we can achieve this is by the means of curettage, chemical agent, ultrasonic, laser, and excision new attachment procedure. Next is prevention of epithelium migration, that I'll be explaining in my next lecture. And last topic is bone graft associated regeneration, in which we will be discussing various type of grafts. So there are non-bone graft associated regeneration, and next is prevention of epithelium migration and bone graft associated regeneration. We'll be starting with non-bone graft associated regeneration. This can be achieved with the removal of junctional epithelium and pocket epithelium. So first is curettage. In curettage, removal of inflamed epithelium will be done. Major disadvantage is it is a non-reliable procedure. Now we'll see how this curettage can be done. In this diagram, because of the plaque and calculus, pocket formation is there. There is inflammation in the gingival tissues. Destruction of periodontal ligament and destruction of bone is there. So first of all, we'll be doing thorough scaling and the root planning, and then we will be removing the lining of epithelium that is inflamed. This is known as curettage. So with the help of periodontal instrument, we'll be scraping the gingival margin, and this procedure is curettage. In this, we can see that we have removed the margin of gingiva. Now, chemical agent. By means of various chemical agent, we can achieve curettage. And various agents that can be used are sodium sulfide, phenol, camphor, and sodium hypochlorite. Now, major disadvantage associated with the chemical agents are the effect of these agents cannot be controlled. So, it is no longer done in clinical practice. Ultrasonic method of curettage. It's a non-reliable procedure because of the lack of vision and lack of tactile sensations. Laser. Major advantage of using laser for curettage is it decontaminate the root and implant surface. It is a biostimulatory. It reduces the load of bacteria, and because of that, better result is there when we are using laser. Next is excision new attachment procedure, which is a very important one-liner question. So what is excision new attachment procedure? As the name suggests, excision. Excision means we will be removing the tissues in order to attain new attachment. It consists of internal bevel incision performed with a surgical knife followed by the removal of excised tissue. No attempt is made to elevate the flap, and after thorough scaling and root planning, sutures will be given. Let us see how. Inflammation is there in the gingiva, so we'll be giving internal bevel incision to the point below the bottom of the pocket, and then we will be removing the inflamed tissues. Thorough scaling and root planning will be done, but we will not be raising the flap. So this is excision new attachment procedure, in which we will be excising the tissues in order to attain new attachment. Now coming on to the bone graft. This is very important topic. Bone graft are material used for replacement or augmentation of bone. They are material which are used for the replacement or augmentation of bone. See, in this picture we can see the osseous defect is there, destruction of fiber is there. We have done thorough scaling and root planning. In order to achieve the bone regeneration, we have put the bone graft so that new bone formation will be there. So what are ideal requisites of bone graft? It should be osteoinductive, it should be predictable, accessible, it should be easily available, it should be safe, it should be biological compatible with the tissues in the form of immunological acceptability, minimum sequelae and rapid vascularization will be there, and minimum operative hazard should be there. Indication of periodontal bone graft in intrabony defect, furcation involvement, implant, extraction socket, sinus lift, ridge augmentation, guided bone regeneration in combination with guided tissue regeneration. I'll be explaining first of all, we'll be discussing first indication in intrabony defect. This is an intrabony defect or vertical defect because the defect is lying below the level of alveolar bone. This is infrabony. It is lying below the level of bone. This is also known as vertical defect. So we will be using bone graft in vertical or infrabony defect. Next is guided bone regeneration. If thin atrophic alveolar ridge is there and because of this we cannot place prosthesis or implant, then we can guide the formation of bone with the help of bone graft and guided tissue regeneration membrane. This is known as guided bone regeneration, and now we can easily put our implant or any other prosthesis. Next indication is sinus lift. This is a sinus and atrophic ridge is there. Because of this atrophic ridge we cannot place the implant. We have put bone graft by making an osteotomy site and we have lifted the floor of sinus. See, the floor of sinus is being lifted and this is bone graft, and now we can easily place our implant. So indication of bone graft is sinus lift. Now classification of bone graft. Now coming on to the classification of bone graft. Based on the origin from where it is obtained, it is classified as autograft, allograft, xenograft and alloplast. Based on osteogenic potential, it is classified as osteoinduction, osteoconduction, osteogenesis and osteoneutral. What is osteoinduction? As the name suggests, induction, it will induce the differentiation of stem cell into osteogenic cell. Osteoconduction, it provides passive porous scaffold upon which new bone can form. Osteogenesis provides stem cell with osteogenic potential which directly lay down new bone. Osteoconduction, explaining in detail, it is the process by which graft material act as a non-viable scaffold, or it only act as a physical structure into and along with new bone can grow. They allow apposition from existing bone but do not produce or trigger bone formation. I have explained this osteoconduction in a diagrammatic representation. We have placed the graft in osseous defect. They are having various pores in it in which blood can easily move in. So the porosity allow angiogenesis and migration of osteoblast, and once osteoblast they have migrated into the bony bone graft, new bone formation will take place, and slowly this material will be resorbed over a period of time. And almost all the bone graft, they have this property of osteoconduction. Osteoinduction. Osteoinduction, as the name suggests, to induce the cell. So a chemical, bone morphogenetic protein, bone morphogenetic protein, it will be inducing the osteoprogenitor cell to form osteoblast, and once osteoblast will form, it will lay down the bone that is there. So the process of induction is known as osteoinduction. Osteoneutral effect, that will merely fill the bony defect without producing any effect and often get encapsulated over a period of time. This is free graft and this is getting encapsulated. Osteogenesis. Osteogenesis, osteobone genesis formation. Osteoblast in the transplanted bone, which is having adequate blood supply and cellular viability. So the osteoblast that is there in the bone graft form new center of ossification within the graft. Example, autogenous graft. Classification based on the origin. Autograft. Autograft is a graft that is transferred from one position to another within same individual. Allograft, obtained from genetically dissimilar individual of the same species. Xenograft, tissue transferred from one species to another species. Alloplast, a synthetic material implanted into the tissues. Now, diagrammatic representation, autograft. Auto means same. So, the graft, it is obtained from the same individual, the one who required the graft. So, the graft is either obtained from the intraoral site or from some extraoral site. So, auto means for the same individual, auto graft, for the same individual. Now, allograft. Allograft is obtained from the same species but genetically different person. So, it is allograft, from genetically dissimilar individual. Now, coming on to the xenograft. Xenograft is a graft that is obtained from animal source. Alloplast. See, plast. Plast means it's a synthetic material. It's being manufactured in the factory and this material is used as a bone graft. Autograft, same. Allograft, some another individual. Xenograft, from the animal source, and alloplast, synthetic material. See, xenograft. In xenograft, there is an X. You can easily draw animal from this X, and it's very easy to remember like this. Xenograft is from animal source. Autograft, a tissue transferred from one position to another within same individual. It is considered as the gold standard because it contains rich source of bone and marrow cell. It is having osteogenic potential and having minimum inflammatory reaction, rapid vascularization around the graft, and potential release of growth and differentiation factor. Sources, either extraoral or intraoral. From extraoral, iliac crest, rib, cranium, and tibial metaphysis. And from intraoral, extraction site, maxillary tuberosity and osseous coagulum. Now, explaining in detail, the autograft that is obtained from the intraoral site, osseous coagulum, it was first described by Earl Robinson. Technique involved, bone is removed with a carbide burr at the speed of 5000 to 30,000 rpm. Advantage the particle size is that the surface area, it has very small surface area, and this surface area provide additional area. The small particle size, it has provide additional surface area for interaction of cellular and vascular element. Disadvantage. Disadvantage is low predictability, and inability to produce adequate material for larger defect. Now, sources: lingual ridge of mandible, exostosis, edentulous ridge, the bone distal to terminal tooth, bone removed by osteoplasty or osteectomy. Bone blend. Bone is removed from predetermined site, triturated in a capsule to a workable plastic mass, and then it's packed into osseous defect. We'll take the bone and we put this bone in the capsule and make a workable mass or plastic-like mass. Cancellous bone marrow transplant. From where we can obtain this cancellous bone marrow? It is obtained from maxillary tuberosity, edentulous area, and healing socket. So first of all, we'll raise the flap, and the cancellous bone marrow is removed with chisel, curette, or with the trephine. This is the trephine. With the help of trephine, we can easily remove the bone. And now the bone graft. It's placed in a Dapen dish. Bone swedging. This technique requires an edentulous area adjacent to defect. Vertical cut is made in edentulous side from where bone is pushed into the defect. I'll be explaining you the bone swedging in a diagrammatic representation. Major disadvantage is technically difficult. It is technically difficult and usefulness is very limited. Now, we can see vertical defect and edentulous area next to it. So we'll be giving a vertical cut and then we'll try to move the bone to the defect area. A vertical cut is given and then we have tried to move the bone in the defect area. So this is known as bone swedging. Now, from extraoral site, iliac autograft. This is no longer in use. Why? Because of post-operative infection, exfoliation and sequestration of the graft, varying rate of healing, root resorption, rapid recurrence of defect in addition to patient expenses. So I guess now you are through with this. What are different terminology? Now, coming on to the allograft. Allograft is a graft transferred between genetically dissimilar members of the same species. And various types available are demineralized freeze-dried, non-demineralized freeze-dried, and iliac cancellous bone. Now, can you guess who will be donating the bone? Yes, answer is right. It is the cadaver. And we'll check how we obtain the bone from the cadaver. Before that, we'll be discussing definition of allograft. So graft obtained from different individual of the same species, it has potential to provoke an immune response, and to suppress the antigenic potential of allograft, it is treated with radiation, freezed, or it is chemically treated. Freeze-dried bone allograft and decalcified freeze-dried bone allograft. Freeze-dried bone allograft, it is obtained from fresh cadaver within 24 hours. And the bone, it is reduced to small pieces of 5 mm in size, and then elimination of bone marrow and cellular debris is done. It is chemically treated. Freeze-dried bone allograft. It is obtained from fresh cadaver within 24 hours. The bone is reduced to the piece size of approximately 5 mm and then elimination of bone marrow and cellular debris is done. It is chemically treated and then it is treated with antimicrobial and antifungal agent and then it is freeze-dried. Let us see how decalcified freeze-dried bone allograft is obtained. As the name suggests, decalcification, or we'll be removing the calcium from the graft. So first, repeated wash will be given to the graft that is obtained from the cadaver. And then bone particle size is further reduced to 250 to 750 micrometer. The dose of gamma radiation is given in order to reduce the antigenicity. And then it is immersed in HCl, or acid bath is given in order to remove all the calcium that is there. And then it is rinsed and packaging is done. Now, so freeze-dried bone graft and decalcified bone graft, So freeze-dried is not demineralized and decalcified is demineralized. Freeze-dried, it offer better space maintenance, but decalcified, freeze-dried, it express DMP, that means it is having osteoinductive property. Freeze-dried, it has slow resorption rate as compared to the other. It is osteoconductive, opposite is osteoinductive, and because it is having calcium in it, it is more radiopaque as compared to the other one. Advantage: availability of in adequate quantity. It is easily available. Predictable result can be obtained. Elimination of an additional donor site. Freeze-dried bone allographic considered as osteoconductive material as compared to decalcified freeze-dried, which is osteoinductive. In periodontal defect, result in significant probing depth reduction, attachment level gain, and osseous regeneration is achieved. Disadvantage: host incompatibility, contamination of the specimen, which lead to infection and potential transmission of disease. Moreover, it can have antigenic potential. It is commercially available in the name of Osex and Encore. Xenograft. Xenograft, tissue transferred from one species to another species. It is osteoconductive. Source: either bovine or from natural coral. In bovine, it is obtained from the cow or from the ox. An anorganic bovine bone. With the new processing and purification method, removal of all the organic components from a bovine source, leaving a bone matrix in unchanged form, which is commercially available as BioOs, BioOs Collagen, and PepGen 15. Advantages: histological studies show significant osseous regeneration and cementum formation. Disadvantages: risk of disease transmission, although which is very negligible. Alloplast, an inert foreign body used for implantation into the tissue. Types: hydroxyapatite, second is ceramic, in ceramic resorbable beta tricalcium phosphate and non-resorbable bioactive glasses. Apart from that, polymer, plaster of Paris and other plastic material is used. Calcium phosphate biomaterial, first hydroxyapatite and then tricalcium phosphate. In hydroxyapatite, calcium to phosphate ratio is 1.67. In tricalcium phosphate, it is 1.5. Hydroxyapatite is non-bioresorbable, whereas other is partially resorbable. The hydroxyapatite is available in macro, porous and microporous form. And commercially available, hydroxyapatite is G-bone and cybograft. And tricalcium phosphate is RTR. It is well tolerated, they have excellent tissue compatibility and do not elicit any inflammatory or foreign body response. These materials are osteoconductive, they are not osteoinductive, result in clinical repair of periodontal lesion. Bioactive glasses, it consists of sodium and calcium salts, phosphates and silicon dioxide. It is used in the form of irregular particles measuring from 90 to 115 micrometer in paleoglass and 300 to 355 micrometer in biogran. When this material came in contact with the tissue fluid, the surface of particle became coated with hydroxycarbonate apatite, which incorporate organic ground proteins such as chondroitin sulfate, glucosamine glycan, which attract the osteoblast and hence bone formation will be there, as explained in this diagram. So this hydroxycarbonate apatite, it will attract various growth factors and macrophages and osteoblasts, so new bone formation will be there. See, apatite crystals are being laid down in bioactive glasses. So bone grafting technique. What is bone grafting technique? First of all, patient selection is done and removal of etiological factor, that means thorough scaling and root planning is done, flap design with the plan of closure, degranulation of defect, root preparation encourage a bleeding bony surface, because if blood will be there, it will be having osteoblasts and other growth factors in it. Then condensation of graft material is to be done properly, good tissue coverage should be there, periodontal dressing is given, and post-surgical care is to be properly taken care of. Combined technique. So various combination technique can be done. For example, we can combine guided tissue regeneration membrane with the bone graft. Now, what will be the outcome of reconstructive surgery? This is a case of periodontitis, and if we have done thorough scaling root planning and we have done regenerative surgery, what can happen? What are possibilities? First is new attachment. See, new bone formation is there. New periodontal ligament formation is there, and healthy gingiva and underlying connective tissue is there. This is new attachment. This is what we want in periodontal reconstructive surgery. So first is either new attachment will be there. Second, what happens? Epithelium proliferate faster as compared to the underlying connective tissue like bone and periodontal ligament, and a long junctional epithelium will form instead of bone and periodontal ligament. And this long junctional epithelium, it is vulnerable to breakdown, so we don't want long junctional epithelium, we want new attachment. Another outcome is root resorption and ankylosis, and recurrence of pocket might be there. So thank you all.